Talbot, and I'm a fourth-year student at the University of Iowa, and I work for University of Iowa Healthcare STEM Education. I'm going to show you how to make some slime today.
First, we're going to take 3/4 cup of Elmer's glue and add it to your bowl or cup or whatever dish you decided to use to mix up your slime. Next, we're going to add 2 tablespoons of baking soda. If you accidentally add a little bit too much like me, what do you think's going to happen? If you repeat this activity, try adjusting the measurements and see what happens to the consistency of your slime. Once you add the glue and the baking soda, it's time to mix it up. This next step is optional, but if you'd like to add color to your slime, you could use food coloring, or I'm using washable paint. Be sure to mix your paint or food coloring really well so you don't get any on your hands or furniture. Now we're going to add the contact solution, which acts as an activator. This is what's going to make your slime slimy. We'll only need 1 tablespoon. Once you start to mix in the contact solution, it'll start to get goopy. If it's still too sticky after you finish mixing it in, you can always add a little bit more contact solution. Once you get the contact solution mixed in, you might want to take it out and knead it with your hands.
So now we have our nice slime. Depending on the measurements that you use, yours might be a little bit thicker, it might be a little bit more watery or sticky, but you just get to play with the measurements until you can figure out the consistency that you like. Thanks for mixing stuff up with us today. I hope you have fun making your slime at home. Thanks for joining us.